a cop, a female cop, LAPD, actually LA Sheriff's Office, was caught on, let's say, the radio having a sexual encounter while on duty. I kid you not. Let's put up a picture of the location where they believe this happened. A Los Angeles Sheriff's Department deputy is now under investigation after allegedly airing the sounds of a sexual encounter over the LASD radio feeds. The female deputy was working at the Men's Central Jail in LA when the sounds of what seemed to be an intimate encounter began airing over the frequency. TMZ obtained a copy of the audio. Let me give you the content. Now, because of particular rules, I am unable to let you listen in on this particular encounter. There are rules in broadcasting that prohibit me from doing so. You can look it up on your own free time. But let me give you a description. In the audio recording, a woman's voice can be heard giggling and warning her partner, "You're gonna rip my underwear." Law enforcement sources told TMZ they suspect the deputy went to a parking structure with another person and accidentally turned her radio on while beginning the interaction. Eventually, the deputy realized the radio was live, but not before other people heard some interesting moans. Now, that is the current narrative coming from the sheriff's office. I don't know. Maybe this is some type of voyeurism, frequency related. Maybe she thought she was on a channel where only certain people could hear. This is the response from the sheriff's department. The LASD told TMZ they were launching an internal investigation into the incident to find out more. There is no lead as to who the other person was engaging with the deputy, but the investigation will inquire if it was another member of the force and they were on the clock. Depending on the outcome of the investigation will depend on the punishment for either person. It could range from suspension to a firing. Now, let me remind everybody, this was done while on duty. This was not done off the clock or she had a radio with her and she was, you know, at home. This did not happen in that context. So likely this happened not only on the clock, it also likely happened on property, government property itself. Okay, a similar situation actually occurred 2 years ago. An LA County Sheriff's deputy allegedly had sex on the Universal Studios lot and the guy had his mic open for all to hear. Apparently, one of the participants was a movie buff because the encounter went down right by the Bates Motel on the lot. You hear a woman moaning as a dispatcher from the sheriff's station repeatedly tries to get her deputy's attention, telling him he had an open mic. The deputy doesn't respond, but eventually the woman does. Okay, what in the hell is going on at the LA County Sheriff's Office? So we have two individuals on record. These are the ones that we can actually report. Do you think this is the only time it has happened? This is starting to look like a culture issue. Now, I don't give a damn what you do in your free time, but while you are working for the taxpayer, you need to be on duty to do a job. I mean, a real job of policing, not harassing people that are unsheltered, but actually real crimes, all right? So the reason this is worthy of covering is because if they would have caught someone doing this on the street, if they would have caught someone doing this in a car, that individual or those individuals would have been charged with multiple crimes, possibly even multiple felonies. But they're able to do it. Why? Why do they feel so empowered to do these things? Because they believe, based on the indoctrination of policing, how the industry has basically been immune to actual accountability, that they can break the law while in uniform, while on duty. All right. Dear brother, thoughts here.
You know, I think you just hit it on the head right there. This is a culture. I mean, you know, you're starting to see we've got repeat offenses here from the same department. It kind of seems like this is almost endemic with that particular police force. And I do think a lot of it has to do with the power that comes along with it. I can do this. You know, this is something I'm not going to get in trouble for. I have such disdain for this position that I hold that sure, I'll go out to my car. It doesn't matter if we're on government property, in government property. We're going to do this because I can. And that mentality, that behavior, that's the slippery slope that we see far too often with policing across the country. Oh, well, if I can get away with this, what else can I do? And that's what we have to be aware of here. I mean, listen, certainly not the worst thing we've had to talk about cops doing, but definitely a problem that does need to be addressed. And I think it needs to be a department-wide investigation, not just into this one individual. Find out what the hell is going on with these officers. Why do they feel they can do this? I mean, bring in actual, you know, therapists, bring in psychologists, talk to everyone and see if you can drill down into what this is really all about. Because I think you're right. I think there's a little more to this within that department than we know.
Yeah, or just fire everybody who does it. It's another way to go.